Here we go. It's a best of seven. Ugo to start. Love to all. Any skills? The skill from Brazil. And first. Play for some time, but he's managed to make his game more aggressive and close to the table. Parallel backhands right down the line. In the back. This point for. Dream matchup, and it's the first time they've played. 2016 versus the bronze medalist eventually, Jun Mizutani. Made for quite a. But a much lower. Placement. There's the backhand. Quick reaction after bringing Ugo in over the table. And as wide as can be on serve and the lead. Curtain is open and bright daylight comes in. The ball will literally disappear. And by literally, I mean figuratively disappear. You just won't be able to see it. Ah, there we go. Can you imagine they catch on fire? Quicker from Koki Niwa. All around the net, beauty. It's funny, I follow out here as well. For yourself as an athlete and the preparation that he goes through. Against the U.S. top player. Three players throughout the year, including other tournaments. And a nice. Look at the draw and realize you've got exciting matches no matter what. If Ugo calls game. Forehand deep to the court. For example. Two in a row. And the spinny backhand. And the ripping backhand does it. 11-9. Calderon. A bit of confidence here. Serves on his side. A little bit tougher for Koki Niwa to earn a high ranking. Ranked number six spot. He's never done it, not on the world tour. Two-handed backhand, but Ugo Calderano doing it against Tomokazu Harimoto became quite famous. Back shots he did twice in the match against Jun Mizutani. Just behind the ears, I love it. In the short side. And deception on the underspin. Continuing to run away with this game, Calderano. Here's the first. And a second back. Like I did, Koki Niwa to serve. And we know Koki Niwa can be dangerous. Quick in at the rim. One in the top 10 throughout the year. Once again, the fast long serve, but it's so useful, that long serve to the backhand. It's so tempting, too. Obviously thinks differently than other people. The rim, it's a piece on the receive now. Short side of the table, the point lead. Koki with the counters, pins call. And from under the table. Let was called. The serve had been troubled before. A nasty chop. His chop block was so nasty inside the table. And fight. Ah, more passive play. An invite. And the backhand does it. 14-1 over Koki Niwa. And the step around. Now I talk about how attacks behind, he can still come back and win anything. Very polite, Koki Niwa. Nice. That counts for Ugo in a major way. Oh, the swatting around that shot. Doesn't want Koki Niwa getting anywhere near score-wise. Not in games, but a quick parallel. Sweet spots. And the short side. Calderano rifles the Austrians. An outstanding rally here. Calderano, for me, played it a little bit safer, which I think was the wise thing to do. He kept more spin on throughout this rally instead of going for broke, but you can really understand the pace here that Koki Niwa puts on the ball. Second to last shot, driven fast. Next one, spinny and arcing. Number six. But Calderano will not. And the soft flick works. Two game points left. Parallel forehands. Oh, goes for the backhand, and it goes just long. Number six, Koki Niwa with the momentum and the narrow escape in the fifth. To start off game number five. Got it. quick. But same with this. The big backhand. And the parallel backhand. Calderano falls back. Soft. And loaded with on the age of 12. He's a very strong player in both. A whole new level to the sport in Brazil. And heavy tops. Koki with one crafty back. But just long here. Backhand just long, a little help for match points. And Koki. Three ill from Brazil. It is Hugo Calderano to take down Koki Niwa, 11-8, 4-2. He moves on and will face Zhao Zihao in the semifinals. A strong performance.